Dawson from creativeguitarstudio.com. Today you're going to get the opportunity to check out an easy to perform pattern that you can play with either finger picking or with a flat pick. We'll cover the chords in it and we'll also learn how to enhance it so that the parts used to play it down sound like they solo more through the addition of some scale tones. After, join me on Patreon for the second half of this lesson where you'll get to watch a bonus video where I'm going to take the ideas from this lesson's arpeggio pattern and build a really beautiful sounding backing track. Plus, along with that, I'm going to also include some excellent scale shapes for you to play a guitar solo with. In the end, all this will come together to provide you with a couple of really cool pieces that'll be a lot of fun to jam on. Now let's begin by learning the shapes that will act as the foundation for this lesson. Before we get started, I just want to let you in on how you can get yourself a copy of the Creative Guitar Studio Handouts Collection ebook. It's easy to do with any donation of $5 or more made on the creativeguitarstudio.com website. You'll instantly receive a copy of this 100-page guitar lesson ebook. It's jam-packed full of chords, scales, arpeggios, music theory, and technique drills. Join the thousands of guitar players who've already received their copy of this amazing lesson book. Just head to creativeguitarstudio.com/donations. To donate and download your copy today. Using pattern picking to play some kind of patterned riff with arpeggiated playing is also sometimes called arpeggiating a chord. And this method takes any chord that can be covered with a fretting shape, and instead of strumming it, we're going to pluck across those notes with our finger picking instead. So we're going to create a finger picked style approach on it. And in our example, we're going to have three chord shapes. We'll have A minor 7, G, and F. And there'll also be a couple of inversions with C with E in the bass and a G with B in the bass. And after that, we're going to get into some scale tones that we'll mix around them too, just to be able to start enhancing the progression a little bit. Now, first of all, let's go through these chord shapes. We've got A minor 7 as our first chord. It's a setup with a bar going across a G, a D, and an E note. And that's giving us just a flattened down technique with our index finger to catch those on the fourth, third, and second strings. Open A is in the bass, generating that A minor 7 sound. And then if we move to the third position, we'll get G, B, and D, and that's taking place on 4th, 3rd, and 2nd strings at the 5th fret, 4th fret, and 3rd fret. Ring finger, middle, and index is taking care of those notes with the open A in the bass again. It's called G major with A in the bass, also sometimes called A9 sus. Now if we move forward into the position here at 5th position again, we get an A, a C, and an F, and that's going to be at fret 7, 5, and 6 of the 4th, 3rd, and 2nd strings. It's an F major chord in the second inversion, but it also has an additional A in the bass, so it's kind of going like A, A, C, F to set itself up. It's a really nice chord. It sounds really rich in that fifth position location. And then we got two more just to wrap up the piece. It's a bar again that we're doing in that fifth position area on fourth, third, and second strings, but we are also including an E in the bass. So that's called first inversion of C major. And then finally, to wrap things up, we have another first inversion, but of G major, and that's going to have a 7th fret B in the bass, and then open 4th, 3rd, and 2nd strings. All right, so with that out of the way, now that you know the shapes, I'm just going to show you the basic principle behind the arpeggiated chord idea that I have for you. It goes like this. So what we're doing is we're starting off on that A minor 7 chord, plucking across that, just letting it ring out, and then moving to that G chord next, making sure that A is down in the bass there, then moving to F after that, and then going through the C with E in the bass into the G chord with B in the bass. And that's all there really is to it. You have to practice that up so those chord changes sound really smooth. And then with the finger plucking, remember that you want to set it up with that classical style plucking. So thumb, index, middle, and ring finger of the plucking hand. And we're staying consistent here too, because all of our chords take place on the same string sets. Except when we get to that very last chord, we just have that movement of that B note into the 7th fret 6th string down below, and then we've got those open strings up on top. And they're done with a pluck, so that movement is the thumb moving down and the fingers curling into the palm of the hand to generate that pluck motion there. All right, so that's the basics of everything. Now, what we're going to do is take a short break, and we're going to come back with some enhancements. I have a small scale segment I want to show you, and then I'm going to show you how to add that around these chords to get a little bit more of a sophisticated sound out of it. And then, of course, on the Patreon lesson, it's really going to be cool. I've got a very much so enhanced version of this with a really different direction, a lot more chord changes and stuff. And then we're also going to move into some cool scale sounds. We're going to get some patterns across the neck for you and train you up on how to go into the world of improvisation with it too. So that's later on the Patreon lesson, but after this short break, we're going to bring in some small scale ideas and then enhance the progression slightly. Any arpeggiated phrase can be built up and enhanced melodically through the use of scale tones, and it isn't all that difficult to do either. What I've got coming up for you next is a way to take the scale that relates to the chord harmony and use a small group of scale tones to create melodic statements around each chord across these arpeggiated ideas. In the end, the scale tones simply act as enhancement to the chords, and we end up with a more sophisticated sound. The first thing I want to do is go over some scale tones with you so you understand what you could maybe add around these chords a little bit, and then I'll give you a demonstration of how you can apply them. So check out this scale shape. I'm starting up on this A here at the first string, 5th fret, because it's an A minor scale. Going down to a G here at 8th fret on the 2nd string, F on 2nd string, E on 2nd string, down to a D on 2nd string. We're going to use this C note, and then come back to the D, and then the E, F, G again, and then up to that A once more. So all together again, A, G, F, E, D, C, D, E, F, G, A. So that's the related scale for all those chord changes that we have. And what I'm going to do now is add some of those notes around each chord. So check this out. Let's talk about that a little bit and break it all down. So I'm going across that A minor 7 chord, but at the top there at that E note on the 2nd string, 5th fret, I'm just adding an F and a G at the 6th and 8th frets. And then from there I'm going to move into 3rd position, take care of the arpeggio layout on the G chord, but I'm also going to add in off the top note D on 3rd fret, 2nd string, I'm going to add an E above that on 5th fret, and then I'm going to return to the D note. So check it out. All right, so I've gone across the chord and then I've added an E in front of that D just to kind of break it up a bit. From there, I'm going to head over to the F major chord. I'll go across that one, but at the top of it, you're going to hear a really quick hammer on. And then we're going to come out of that to this C note here on the 3rd string, 5th fret. So check this out. That really quick hammer-on is a grace note hammer-on. We sustain it for a little bit, just a second there. And then we come out of it by way of the E note there on the 5th fret of the 2nd string. And then we have this 5th fret C here on 3rd string as the note that we're headed to overall. All right, so that covers the F chord. And then when we move into those last two chords, we're doing something a little bit different into that E bass note on the 5th string. It's just a really quick grace note slide from 5 to 7. So that's really quick there on that 5th fret to 7th fret on 5th string. We're going to play that upper part of that chord. So that's the bar on the 5th fret there. And then we're going to take care of that low B on the 7th fret 6th string. And we're going to grab these two open strings here, the 4th and the 3rd. You notice I omitted the top B string this time. I just changed it up a little bit there. You know, there's a lot of work that can come from adding notes, and there's, you know, a lot of times that can sound really good. But don't forget, there's a lot of nice sounds that come from removing notes too. So always think in both directions there. So that's our ending idea, just a little bit smoother with only the fourth and third strings at that last hit. So you put it all together, you got a really nice sound here. So it's slightly enhanced with that scale tone idea, and you can tell it really does make quite a serious difference to things. So basically, we're kind of wrapped up here on the YouTube lesson, and I hope that you're going to join me next on Patreon, because it's going to be a lot of fun there with this lesson. We're going to take these chords and the changes that we've been working on here, and we're going to really enhance it. We're going to change things up, make this progression a little bit different. We're going to make it longer. Instead of 4 bars, it's going to be 8 bars long. And then what's really cool is, as a Patreon member, you not only get a PDF download of a handout with everything in detail that we do in this lesson plan, but we're also going to be looking at getting you a jam track download so that you can work on the chord changes that we're going to have in an enhanced sense. And we're going to get you some scale shapes along the upper string sets of the guitar and talk about improvising over these sounds as well. It's going to be a lot of fun. You're going to learn a lot of stuff, not only about how to enhance progressions even further, but also how to start getting some scales and guitar soloing going on top of everything as well. So I hope to see you next on Patreon. Just go to patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. If you're signed up as one of my $15 a month Patreon members, you'll get to watch a bonus video where I'm going to take the chords and the scale from this lesson's arpeggio pattern and build another really beautiful sounding backing track. Plus, along with doing that, I'm also going to include some excellent scale shapes for you to play a guitar solo with. In the end, all of this will come together to provide you with another really cool piece that'll be a lot of fun to jam on. Plus, as a Patreon member, along with that bonus video, you'll get a jam track and you'll also get to download a very detailed PDF handout that shows you all of the examples in both music notation and in tab. Plus, it also includes a number of additional tips and explanations that you don't get in the video lessons. So head over to my Patreon, become a $15 a month supporter today at patreon.com/creativeguitarstudio. And guys, if you want to help support the channel even further, check out our Teespring store. The link is located inside the top pinned comment below. The store has all kinds of great guitar designs on t-shirts, sweaters, bags, hats, and coffee cups. All the designs and the prints are top quality. In fact, I'm wearing one of the shirts right now. Let me tell you, the fabrics and the prints are just fantastic. Go and check out the store, and if you're a member of the website, use your Creative Guitar Studio coupon code to get your members discount at checkout on Teespring. Now, if you found this video helpful, make sure you leave your comments and give the video a thumbs up below. And remember, if you're looking for a step-by-step guitar program that puts real tested methods into a proven guitar course, not just random YouTube videos, it's all available over at creativeguitarstudio.com. Plus, you're going to want to make sure you're seeing all my guitar lessons here on YouTube. So go and turn on those notifications, ring the bell, and subscribe to the channel. All right, guys, I'll be back here again real soon with another video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again next time. Bye for now. I've got 25 years experience teaching guitar and have written a well-organized step-by-step guitar course. Head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up for a free membership today. Join the thousands of members worldwide who have already enrolled. There's no need to try learning the guitar on your own. Let me help you become the best guitar player that you can be.